The bird flew down, and in order to distract the wolf, he almost touched the wolf's head with her wings, while the wolf snapped angrily at her from this side and that. Oh, how that little bird upset the wolf. And oh, how the wolf wanted to catch her and eat her. But the bird was much more clever than the wolf. And the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it, no matter how hard he tried. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso with his rope, and carefully letting it down, he caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump about wildly, trying to get loose. But Peter tied the other end of the rope to the tree. And the wolf's jumping only made the rope around his tail get tighter. Just then, the hunters came out of the woods. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they came. Thank you. sitting up in the tree, said, "Wait, don't shoot. Bertie and I have already caught the wolf. Come and help us take him to the zoo." And so, off they went to the zoo. Just imagine the triumphant procession. Peter, proudly at the head. Close behind Peter, the hunters leading the wolf. And winding up the procession, Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather tossed his head discontentedly. "Well," he said, "and if Peter hadn't caught the wolf, what then?" High above them flew the little bird, chirping merrily. "My," she said, "what fine ones we are, Peter and I. Look at what we've caught."